Fox News alert, and the United States has issued a warning to U.S. personnel in Libya to leave immediately as that bloody crackdown in Libya intensifies. Chaos and bloodshed spreading across the Middle East. Massive protests breaking out in cities across Libya, including violent clashes in Tripoli. And tensions remain high in Bahrain as well, where demonstrators are demanding the downfall of the entire monarchy of that small nation. In Yemen, new scuffles break out in the capital as thousands of protesters gather to voice their anger at that country's longtime ruler. Christian Whiton was an advisor to the Undersecretary of State during the Bush administration. So much turmoil in so many countries, Christian. Are they all related? Are they all looking for the same thing?
In a nutshell, yes. We are seeing a large, consistent wave of pro-democracy activists. There are, of course, people who will try to divert this onto other objectives like Islamism. And, of course, there are Arabists, the dictators who are in charge of many of these countries who still want things to go their way. But, yes, I'd say a broad pro-democracy wave. You mentioned all the places it's hitting. But perhaps most significant today is Libya, where this would be the toughest regime to be taken down if, in fact, the Libyan people succeed in taking down a regime that has lorded over them since 1969.
Well, talking about a bloody regime, these reports that Libyan Air Force jets are actually firing on civilian protesters on the ground, that suggests that Colonel Gaddafi or his military are feeling very threatened right now.
It does. It, you know, when this is said and done, we may find that this level of regime violence comes close to the 1989 Tiananmen Square massacre that was conducted by the Chinese government, or perhaps some of Saddam Hussein's activities in the wake of the Gulf War. But it's remarkable that the Libyan people have persisted. Some media have reported that the sort of barrier of fear that existed has been torn down and has reached a critical mass. You know, when these protests started, the big question was whether they would go beyond Benghazi, where there had previously been anti-Qaddafi protests, and they have. They are comprehensive across much of the country, and despite the intense violence, seem to be persisting.
There are reports that a couple of Mirage fighter jets belonging to the Libyan Air Force have landed at an airport in Malta, a couple of helicopters as well. It sounds as though these are appeals for asylum by the pilots and maybe some family members, because those helicopters were apparently loaded. There are also reports that Libyan government officials have switched sides and publicly announced that they are joining the protesters. Does it seem to you that Gaddafi's government doesn't have long to stand?
It's very hard to tell. We know with 100% certainty he's willing to use violence against his people. It's already happening. So the question is how many people are left to follow out that order. And there's also the question of U.S. policy. The State Department did condemn the violence that's being used by Gaddafi against his own people yesterday. But we've yet to make it crystal clear that we favor the democracy protesters and we want them to take control of this country and oust Gaddafi. But the developments, especially regime officials changing sides, is something that's positive. So this is something where the White House, through some other clear messaging, such as expelling the Libyan ambassador to the U.S. and other steps, could help out these protesters.
But is it sometimes better to deal with the devil that you know? I mean, Gaddafi is a brute, but he did get rid of his nuclear program, that kind of thing.
He did, and that which took place after the Iraq War, and he saw the consequences for you know, conduct like his in a post 9/11 environment, also other rapprochement with both the United States, with Britain, with others in the West. But the fact is, this is an evil regime. It's a dangerous regime, and like the other dictators of the Middle East, it runs the risk of creating an even worse outcome, which is an Islamist-run country that's aligned with the Tehran regime. So the people you're seeing in the streets, quite remarkably, as in Egypt, as in Tunisia, as in Bahrain, want democracy, want secular democracy. So they ought to be encouraging them. You know, we can still have relations, but I don't think we'll be accomplishing much with Gaddafi's envoy to the U.S. or our envoy to the Gaddafi government. So a change of personnel and a different approach, I think, is warranted in this case.
And as you point out, probably the most important overseas development during the Obama presidency thus far. Christian Whiton, thank you.